Hello, everybody. Welcome back to our library. Today, we are going to be showing you Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets by J.K. Rowling, a beautiful edition illustrated by Jim Kay. Here you can see this wonderful slipcase that it came in with a spider on it. We think that it's Aragorn, who you know from the Chamber of Secrets. And here you see the gold gilded pages of this wonderful edition, as well as a beautiful gold illustration of what looks like the herbology place in Hogwarts. The Chamber of Secrets is the second book in the Harry Potter sequence. It is, you know, still an introduction into Harry Potter that I read when I was, I think, 14, 15 years old. And it really continued on with the magic from the first book, Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone. The book... Here you could see the illustrations of what's to come with the spiders on the table of contents. It starts with the worst birthday. Of course, we know Harry Potter is back with the Dursleys. Here he is on his birthday. And here is Dudley eating all the food that he's allowed to eat, being happy in his piggy ways. And here on the worst birthday, we are introduced to Dobby, the house elf, who Harry Potter has never seen a house elf before. And Dobby is trying to get Harry Potter to stop going to Hogwarts. He has stopped all of Harry's letters. Harry is so sad, thinking his friends had forgotten him. And Dobby says, "You must not go back to Hogwarts." He gets Harry Potter in trouble with the Dursleys, who lock him up in his room. They put bars in his room. But Ron and his brothers come to the rescue in a flying car here. You see the wonderful illustration of them flying high above in England, going to the Burrow, where the Weasleys live. Here is the Burrow. Harry Potter is introduced to this wonderful, like, he knew the Weasleys and the Wizarding family before, but now he sees their home life and how unusual it is for him, but how warm and loving. So they all go to Diagon Alley to get their supplies. And that is the first time that Harry Potter uses flu powder and the flu network to get through to the new place. That is how wizards travel when they can't apparate. And of course, they're too young to apparate. And he gets to the wrong part of Diagon Alley, and he gets to the creepy part with all these creepy stores, and he's all by himself. But thankfully, Hagrid is there. And he leads him away from Flourish and Botts and takes him to Diagon Alley, where the Weasleys are waiting for him. Here you see Diagon Alley, all the wonderful shops that they have to go to. This is where all the Hogwarts students get their books and their cloaks and their wands and their potions. And once they get to Diagon Alley, they meet a wizard there who's doing a book signing. And the next time that they try to get through the platform 9 3/4, Harry and Ron aren't able to. And they're so worried that the Weasleys can't get back and they can't get through Hogwarts that they take the flying car and they follow the Hogwarts Express to Hogwarts. So here's them flying over. And when they get to Hogwarts, they crash into the Whomping Willow. And this is our second introduction to Gilderoy Lockhart. Gilderoy Lockhart is a well-known author and wizard. His demographic is women. He goes by his good looks. But really, you see that he is not a talented wizard at all when he starts to teach defense against the dark arts, and he takes out a bunch of pixies that run around the whole classroom, fly around, and he can't even deal with them. Moving on, we have Mudbloods and Murmurs. So during the crash into the Whomping Willow, when Ron and Harry fly the car, Ron's wand breaks and it starts backfiring a bunch of spells. And here you see Ron try to curse Draco Malfoy for calling Hermione a mudblood, but really when he said eat slugs, it backfired. So he started vomiting up slugs. And then there's the Death Day party. So these are when nearly Headless Nick, instead of having a birthday, has a death day party. And here you see the death day party. And, you know, all the creepy accoutrements that come along with it. Here's Nearly Headless Nick on his dead ghost horse. And here's where we start getting introductions into the creepy, creepy world of the Chamber of Secrets. All of a sudden, Harry starts hearing voices, and he doesn't know where they're coming from, and it doesn't seem that anybody else knows. He hears kill, kill, kill. And he doesn't know what is going on. This is an introduction to a very great character, Moaning Myrtle. Of course, she haunts one of the women's bathrooms in Hogwarts. And then we move on to Quidditch. It's a huge game that's going on. And Harry, of course, is the Gryffindor seeker. He's the one who has to get the golden snitch, which has a lot of points, and ends the game. But there's a rogue bludger. So bludgers are the balls in Quidditch, which are trying to hit the players so that they aren't able to score. And this rogue bludger seems to only be after Harry. And it's chasing after him. And you see Draco chasing after Harry. They're both trying to get the snitch, but Harry's also just trying to get away from this rogue bludger. And Harry does fall and hurt his arm. And instead of taking him to Madame Pomfrey, who could mend a broken arm so quickly, Gilderoy Lockhart instead does a spell that completely disappears his bones. And he has to get to Skellagro and grow his bones back, which is very, very painful. And here we have the Dueling Club, which Gilderoy Lockhart and Professor Snape are showing the second years how to duel properly as wizards. And Professor Snape, he makes a snake. And without knowing it, Harry talks Parseltongue to the snake, and the snake understands him. But nobody else can speak Parseltongue, and it looks like he's goading on the snake. So people are starting to assume that he is possibly the one to open the Chamber of Secrets, or has something to do with it, because it has something to do with Slytherin and the person who started the Slytherin house. And maybe he's the heir of Slytherin since he could speak Parseltongue. So Hermione and Ron and Harry concoct Polyjuice Potion to turn in to Draco's friends so they can go and ask Draco. Maybe he's the heir of Slytherin. The heir of Slytherin doesn't want people who aren't purebloods in Hogwarts. However, when they do get into the Slytherin common room to ask Draco about it, they realize he doesn't know it. And in the Polyjuice potion, Hermione, she turns herself into a cat, thinking it was a Slytherin girl's hair that she put in the potion, but really was a cat. And then Harry Potter finds very important article in this whole book, the very secret diary. And as he starts writing in this diary, the ink disappears and somebody responds. They say, "I'm Tom Riddle." So of course Harry uses this opportunity to see, do you know anything about the Chamber of Secrets? Because Harry Potter is so worried that he's hearing these voices. He doesn't know what's going on. People are getting petrified. Students are getting petrified. And he doesn't want Hogwarts to close. Of course, he doesn't want Hogwarts to be in danger too. And this secret diary takes him into a memory. And here you see this vibrant color of Harry falling into this memory. And as he falls into this memory, he sees what appears to be a young Hagrid getting expelled from school because this person, Tom Riddle, thinks that the monster that killed a girl 50 years back in Hogwarts is actually Aragorn, who is a pet of Hagrid's. And we know from the beginning that Hagrid has this really, really fond affection for dangerous animals. Here is Hagrid, and unfortunately Cornelius Fudge, he comes to arrest Hagrid because the Chamber of Secrets has been opened again, and they think Hagrid has something to do with it. Dumbledore, always loyal to Hagrid, never really believed that Hagrid had anything to do with the first time was there for him. Harry and Ron are there, and when that happens, underneath Harry's invisibility cloak, and as Hagrid's leaving, he just said, "Follow the spiders if you want to know something." And that is when we get introduced to Aragorn. Now, earlier in the book, Ron and Harry has seen that spiders have been acting very strangely in the castle, scurrying away from it. So they follow the spiders into the Forbidden Forest, and that's where they meet a huge spider, Aragorn, who speaks to Harry and Ron and says that when he was in Hogwarts, he didn't open the Chamber of Secrets. The only part of Hogwarts he ever saw was the box that Hagrid kept him in, and that what the beast that is in the Chamber of Secrets, spiders fear, and that's why they're scurrying. The Aragorn's family tries to attack Ron and Harry. They are able to escape with the help of the flying car and get back to Hogwarts, seemingly unscathed, but then they come back to awful, awful news. The Chamber of Secrets has finally taken its first victim. While the other victims were just petrified and they were working on a remedy to unpetrify them, they find out that the first student taken is Ginny Weasley, who is Ron's younger sister. And they decide to go into the Chamber of Secrets. They realize that the Chamber of Secrets was the entrance is in the bathroom that Moaning Myrtle haunts. That they talk to her and they say that that is where she died. She was actually the victim 50 years ago. Gilderoy Lockhart is tricked into going with them and he tries to get away. He tries to give them a memory spell, which is how he wrote all his books. He stole memories from all these other and adventures from all these other wizards, but it backfires on him and he loses him. So it's up to Ron and Harry to save Ginny. And this is when they come to the Chamber of Secrets and meet Tom Riddle. And and they meet the monster, who is a basilisk. And if you look at the basilisk and they make eye contact, you die. Also, bite is poisonous. It is a huge monster snake. And Tom Riddle explains that he wants to kill Ginny Weasley, because as Ginny Weasley dies, he becomes more and more powerful. And he wanted to meet Harry, and Harry doesn't understand. I came after you. But Tom Riddle says, I am Lord Voldemort, in a memory, and he is able to take this form again because he is really using Ginny Weasley's life force to get to it. But of course, Dumbledore is always there to rescue, and he said before that help will always come to those in Hogwarts who ask for it. And Harry gets the Gryffindor sword to help with that, and that's him holding the sword to gouge out the eyes of the basilisk. And at the same time, you see in the corner, Fox the Phoenix is there. And when Harry is hurt by the basilisk, Fox comes and cries, and Phoenix's tears are healing. So Harry is able to save Ginny. And with Fox, they're able to get out of the Chamber of Secrets while Tom Riddle disappears and is just a memory again. Here you see the Sword of Gryffindor. And through this all, afterwards, of course, Dumbledore, you know, they're going through the what really happened. And it turns out when Harry and the Weasleys were in Diagon Alley, and here you see a beautiful map of Diagon Alley, an illustration of it. Malfoy's father, Lucius Malfoy, put the diary into Ginny Weasley's cauldron, and that's how she got the diary. And she spoke all about Harry Potter, who she has a huge crush on, and he wanted the Chamber of Secrets to be open again. He didn't know that Tom Riddle would come back, but he wanted to cause chaos. And then that is when Harry finds out that Dobby the house elf is really part of the Malfoys. And the way that a house elf gets his freedom is that he's given clothes by his master. So Harry tricks Lucius Malfoy in giving a sock to Dobby, and Dobby becomes a free elf. And that is a wonderful ending to Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets, the second book in the series, in this wonderful, wonderful illustrated edition. Thank you so much. We hope to present to you more of this collection of Harry Potter, as well as other books that we get into our collection. Thank you.